What's up, y'all? DHRT, welcome back to my channel. So we're gonna react to Undertaker with Paul Bearer versus Dwayne Gill something back in 1992. So I'm sorry if I mispronounced his last name. If you guys know what's this dude's name Undertaker is facing, comment down below. So without further ado, let's get on with this reaction.
Razor Ramon in action in the squared circle, hopefully, Dwayne very soon Gill. Here in the WWF.
Seems like a pretty cool dude.
Speaking of cool dudes, look at this. Standing ovation.
Yeah. When Undertaker became babyface, when he fought Jake the Snake Roberts at WrestleMania, his popularity just grew over that. And the rest was history. Look at that. Girl, your hair. Man, Undertaker was the man back then, and he's still the man today. I don't care what y'all say. Yes, he's old and he's still wrestling, but come on, he's the Undertaker. Get over it. I think sometime around 1993, when Undertaker was making his grand entrance, that's when they started doing the lights going out there and the spotlight pointed on Undertaker. Yeah.
He might look a little bit different after Mr. Fuji and the Berserker get through with the McMahon. He gets that sword, sticks it through the middle of the Undertaker. He'll stay down.
Yeah. I would think he would, then again. I'm not too sure.
R.I.P. Paul Bearer. One of the greatest managers of all time.
If any human being can stop the Undertaker, he's almost supernatural.
I have to agree with you. I've never seen anybody come down the lane a long time that looks and acts the way the Undertaker does.
Ah, yeah. It's almost like a vice-like grip the Undertaker has. Look at that. Wow, down to the canvas.
Yo, this nigga is like scary from hit to toe.
Mr. Fuji is the most devious man in wrestling. If there's a way to
sorry if I said the N-word, y'all.
The Undertaker down, Fuji and the Berserker, they're the couple of guys that can do it.
And take a look at this. The agility possessed by one of the biggest men in all of the WWF. The power from the earth down.
Crushing across the back of Dwayne Gill.
Wow, is that impressive, big man.
And what made me love about Undertaker so much is his hair, his hair over his face. That right there is what made him look so scary back then. I wish they could have gone back to that route back in 2004 when he returned to WrestleMania 20 with the Dead Man gimmick. That would have made my childhood so good, but I guess he got used to, you know, his hair on the side of his face rather than over his face, you know.
The Undertaker on the cover of this month's edition of Spotlight Magazine. The Undertaker, the Grim Reaper of Wayward Souls. And it looks like Dwayne Gill is going to be a wayward soul. Nobody gets up after the tombstone. Nobody.
Not yet.
Not ever. Paul Bearer. The Undertaker. Victorious. And henceforth, the body bag.
Yeah.
I'd like to see the Berserker take that sword and use it like a Vegematic and slice this man down to size.
And I'd like to see either Berserker or Mr. Fuji leave
body bag.
I wonder why, you know, I wonder why they don't do that no more. What can I say? This is a classic match. Undertaker is one of my favorite wrestlers of all time. He still is today. Somewhere down the line alongside greats like Steve Austin, The Rock, Triple H, among others. John Cena don't count. I don't care about him. Him or Roman Reigns. But, yeah, this is a good match. And shout out to Undertaker fans, the creatures of the night. And shout outs to the DH Army, y'all. We're almost at 500 subs, so let's keep the ground going. And if you enjoy, my reaction, excuse my tongue twirling, and if you enjoy this content, thumbs up, follow me on Instagram, and click the bell, be a part of the DH Army. Until then, DHR2, much love, and may y'all rest in peace.